In this video, create checkpoint objects. When player touch a checkpoint, its name will be saved to a list variable. After save a checkpoint, when the game reloaded or player is died, player will be moved to the current checkpoint position. What we need to repair for now. Create a 3D object with name checkpoint. When player touch this object, it will be destroyed. Now select your checkpoint object. Add new component box collider. And adjust its size bigger for player can step on it. Then make sure its trigger turned on. Next step, add new visual scripting script on this checkpoint. Open the script. Use on trigger enter to check if player step on this checkpoint. The script inside checkpoint object. So input this will be object checkpoint. Compare if it's touching object with tag player. Make sure you add the tag player on your main player character. If player touch this checkpoint, say this checkpoint name. After that, destroy this checkpoint also. We need to give it some time before deleting this object, because we need to get its name to save it. Next step, add new checkpoint to a list variable. Let's check if the collider of this checkpoint is working. Let's play to test it. Alright, the collider worked well. In Roblox, player can use many checkpoint locations to save the current position of player. Let's duplicate and add more checkpoints. Each checkpoint should have different names. We use this name to get the object later. All checkpoint colliders should work too. Let's get back to our script. Create a new save variable. Name it checkpoint list. And use dictionary type to save it. You can use IoT list also. List and dictionary are same to use. After player touch a checkpoint object, let's check if this checkpoint is already saved or not. We use dictionary contains key to check it. Input key name will be the name of checkpoint. It has not been saved. Save this checkpoint name to the list variable. Key name will be the name of checkpoint object. And value is true or false. Because checkpoint list is a save variable, we must use not save variables to save it for next time game open. Let's play to see if it works. Name checkpoint number 1 is saved successfully. If player touch another checkpoint object, its name will be added to the list names too. Next step, if player died or game is reloaded, let's move player to the save checkpoint position. First, let's add another empty object, name it game manager, and add new visual scripting script on this object. In this script, we will load player to position of the newest checkpoint. To make sure all variables are loaded, I use timer at onStart. Give it a little time after game is loaded. Next, add new custom event to get the checkpoint object. First, we need to check if there is any checkpoint is saved. If there is any saved checkpoint, list count items will be greater than 0. The newest checkpoint always will be the last item from the list variable. Now we need to get its key name or the checkpoint name. To do that, open project settings, visual scripting. Click on plus icon. Then search for dictionary ng. Now you can search for dictionary get key. It will return the key name or checkpoint name that we need. Let's press play to see if it works. It shows the current save checkpoint name successfully. Next step, move player to that checkpoint position. Let's get that checkpoint object from its name. then get position and move player there. Right after game is loaded, player is moved to the safe checkpoint position. Take a slower look, player is loaded under the rail. Sometimes it will push player down and fall under the rail. To fix it, let's create a new object inside checkpoint object. Move this object above the rail. I will name it respawn location. Then move it up to be the first giant object. Do the same for all checkpoint objects. Select all others respawn location. Remove collider and make them invisible. Next, back to our script. Then get the first giant object. And we're going to move player to this giant object position. Now player is loaded at middle of the air like other games. Next step, let's destroy old checkpoints after game is loaded. Open checkpoint script. At onStart, when game is loaded, we're going to check if this checkpoint is added and saved by player. Use dictionary contains key. Input key name will be the name of current checkpoint. If the checkpoint has been saved, let's destroy it after 1 second since the game is loaded. Why we destroy it after 1 second? Because if we destroy it sooner, player cannot get the safe checkpoint position to move to. Press play to see the result. After game is loaded, all safe checkpoints were destroyed. Let's test it with next checkpoint. New checkpoint is saved. And if player is died, player will be loaded at the new checkpoint position. When player is loaded, you can see the glitch. To make it smoother, I will add a black screen at game start. Adjust the UI size scale. And edit size black image cover all the screen. Then put it to inactive at first. We will show it when game is loaded. To get the inactive object, you must add it to a variable to call it. Next, open the Game Manager script. Add new custom event at onStart. Load black screen. We already have black screen object. Use game set active to turn it on. After 2 seconds, when player is moved to save checkpoint position, we're going to turn off the black screen again. Let's press play to see our final result. Created a loading screen successfully. In Roblox, loading screen's opacity is turned off smoothly. Let's use a macro to do that quickly. You can get this visual scripting plus from link under video. After importing, you will get this folder. Open macro twin. Add prefab to the hierarchy. To use it, step 1, copy script macro twin to object. Step 2, open script use twin to get event to use. You can smoothly position, scale, angle, or change opacity smoothly. Copy this event. After 1 second, we will change the black screen opacity smoothly to 0. Object will be black screen image. Twin property will be opacity. Change duration to 2 seconds. Select one animation type as you want. I will keep smooth out animation. Opacity value 1 is 100% visible. And 0 is invisible completely. With only one simple event, loading screen is turned off smoothly now. You understand how to save and load checkpoint already. Comment below any tutorials you want me to make in next video. Thank you for watching.